Welcome to Story of Art. Today we will discuss Far Eastern Art, Part 2, Japanese Art. Japanese have had a long and rich history of art that stretches back to ancient times. In fact, some of the oldest artifacts known to man belong to the Japanese. The different eras of art have been given names according to the places where the government was located. Historians claim that the earliest inhabitants of Japan was a tribe called Ainu. They were the ones responsible for the early artifacts of Japan. With time, the Ainu people started having an influence on the northern areas of Japan. The people of this region were called the German people, and consequently the period is known as the Jomon and Yayoi period. Around 660 BC, according to old legends and Chinese chronicles, Jimmu became the first emperor of Japan. Circa in 350 BC, the Yayoi people invaded Japan. Remnants from this period are pottery vessels and clay figures. Copper and bronze was used for weapons and religious artifacts like bells. Another important era was the Kofun period in 250 BC. The culture of the time period is also known as the Haniwa culture, which consisted of typical sculptures that were found on tombs. Bronze mirrors belonging to this time period have also been found. In 552, at the beginning of the Asuka period, Buddhism was brought from China to Japan. This had a decisive impact on the development of Japanese arts. It brought the influence of the advanced Chinese culture and new techniques in arts and architecture to Japan. In 604, the first Japanese constitution was introduced. It reflected the idea of the centralized rule exercised in China. By the 7th century, Buddhism was fully established in Japan. In 710, the city of Nara in the province of Yamato became the capital of Japan. During the Nara period, under the influence of Buddhism, Japan assimilated the style of the Chinese Tang dynasty. Many Buddhist temples were constructed focused around the area of Nara. The earliest Japanese sculptures of the Buddha are dated to the 6th and 7th century. They ultimately derived from the 1st to 3rd century CE Greco-Buddhist art of Gandhara. India, characterized by flowing dress patterns and realistic rendering, on which Chinese and Korean artistic traits were superimposed. The earliest Buddhist structures still extant in Japan, and the oldest wooden buildings in the Far East are found at the Horyoji to the southwest of Nara. First built in the early 7th century as the private temple of Crown Prince Shotoku, it consists of 41 independent buildings. The most important ones, the main worship hall or Kondo, that is Golden Hall, and Goju no To, 5-story pagoda, stand in the center of an open area surrounded by a roofed cloister. The Kondo, in the style of Chinese worship halls, is a 2-story structure of post and beam construction, capped by an irimoya or hipped gabled roof of ceramic tiles. In 794, the capital was moved to Heian-kyo, now Kyoto. During the Heian period, a more distinctive Japanese art culture developed. Around 1005, Lady Murasaki Shikibu, a lady in waiting to the Empress Akiko, wrote the tale of Genji Monogatari. It is believed to be the first novel in the world. It deals with the life and love adventures of Prince Genji, a kind of medieval womanizer. The oldest surviving tale of Genji hand scrolls, Imaki, were painted in the late Heian period. generations of court-appointed painters, mostly from the Tosa family, kept the tradition of tale of Genji painting alive. By the middle of the Edo period, 1600 to 1868, when this work was completed, most literate people knew the narrative well. Artists continued to produce Genji hand scrolls in the colorful and highly decorative Yamato-e style of the Heian period originals. Art historians often refer to Tale of Genji hand scrolls as monoscenic narratives. A short section of text and an illustration represents each chapter of the tale. Although variations appeared from time to time, in general, the selection of text image combinations was fairly standard. Emaki, or the horizontal scrolls developed in the Heian period, also serve as some of the earliest and greatest examples of the otoko-e, that is men's pictures, and onna-e, that is women's pictures, styles of painting. There are many fine differences in the two styles, appealing to the aesthetic preferences of the genders. But perhaps most easily noticeable are the differences in subject matter. Onna-e, epitomized by the tale of Genji hand scroll, typically deals with court life, particularly the court ladies, and with romantic themes. Otoko-e, on the other hand, often recorded historical events, particularly battles. The siege of the Sanjo Palace in 1160, depicted in the Night Attack on the Sanjo Palace section of the Heiji Monogatari hand scroll, is a famous example of this style. In the 9th century, the emperors began to retire from the business of the governing the country. The Fujiwara family rose to power. During the Fujiwara period, Japanese arts and literature flourished. In the Fujiwara period, Pure Land Buddhism, which offered easy salvation through belief in Amitabha, the Buddha of the Western Paradise, became popular. They created a new form of Buddha Hall, the Amida Hall, which blends the secular with the religious and houses one or more Buddha images within a structure, resembling the mansions of the nobility. In 1180, a fierce war broke out between the powerful clans of the Minamoto and the Taira. After achieving final victory in the naval battle of Dhanaura, the Minamoto established a new government in Kamakura. In 1192, Yoritomo became the first shogun. The Kamakura shogunate represented the real power in the country until the resignation of the last shogun in 1867. The imperial court in Kyoto was downgraded to a purely titular power. The shift of power from the nobility to the class of tesumurai warriors had its influence on Japanese arts. During the Kamakura period, more realistic and popularized art forms emerged. The Japanese calligraphy and the Japanese tea ceremony were initiated. Realism, now a popularizing trend, and a classical revival characterized the art of the Kamakura period. In the Kamakura period, Kyoto and Nara remained the centers of artistic production and high culture. In 1252, the great Kamakura Buddha was constructed. The huge statue was part of the Kotokuin temple of the Jodo sect. The Kamakura Buddha was originally housed in a great hall that was destroyed by a storm in 1369. In this period, Kei's school of sculptures, particularly Ankei, created a new, more realistic style of sculpture. The two neo-guardian images in 1203 in the great south gate of the Todaiji in Nara illustrate Ankei's dynamic supra-realistic style. The images, about 8 meter, that is about 26 feet tall, were carved of multiple blocks in a period of about 3 months. It points to a developed studio system of artisans working under the direction of a master sculptor. Anke's polychromed wood sculptures of two Indian sages, Muchaku and Seishin, the legendary founders of the Hoso sect, are among the most accomplished realistic works of the period. One of the most famous works of this period is an Amitabha triad completed in 1195. In Jodo ji in Ono, created by K.K., Anke's successor, the Kigon Engi Imaki, the illustrated history of the founding of the Kigon sect, is an excellent example of the popular trend in Kamakura painting. Ashikaga period. The Muromachi period is also called the Ashikaga period after the military clan that took control of the shogunate. The residence was moved back to Kyoto to the Muromachi district of the city. The history of Japanese art was marked by a move backwards to a more aristocratic character. Zen Buddhism achieved popularity in Japan and influenced Japanese artists and artisans. Many orders were placed for the construction and decoration of Zen temples. Because of secular ventures and trading missions to China organized by Zen temples, many Chinese paintings and objects of art were imported into Japan and profoundly influenced Japanese artists working for Zen temples and the shogunate. Not only did these imports change the subject matter of painting, but they also modified the use of color. The bright colors of Yamato-e yielded to the monochromes of painting in the Chinese manner, where paintings generally only have black and white or different tones of a single color. The third shogun, Ashikaga Yoshimitsu, built the Kinkauji temple called the Golden Pavilion and its gardens. During the Muromachi period, the art of intricate gardening and ikebana reached a high level of refinement in the history of Japanese arts. Painting reached high artistic levels. The best known painters are two monks, Shubun and Sishu. Buddhist monasteries were very wealthy and powerful during this period. Sishu, unlike most artists of the period, was able to journey to China and study Chinese painting at its source. Landscape of the Four Seasons, Sansoi Chokan, in 1486, is one of the Sishu's most accomplished works, depicting a continuing landscape through the four seasons. Typical of early Muromachi painting is the depiction by the priest painter Kao of the legendary monk Kensu at the moment he achieved enlightenment. This type of painting was executed with quick brush strokes and a minimum of detail. Catching a catfish with a gourd, early 15th century, Taizo in Myoshin-ji, Kyoto, by the priest painter Josetsu, marks a turning point in the Muromachi painting. It is generally assumed that the new style of this painting, executed about 1413, refers to a more Chinese sense of deep space within the picture plane. In general, Japanese painting of the Muromachi period includes a deep sense of space and attempts to tell a story. In the succeeding Momoyama period between 1573 to 1603, the traditional style of landscape painting was developed, most often produced on gigantic screens that filled entire rooms. During the end of the 15th century, the Ashikaga shogunate had lost control over the country. Powerful feudal lords had ravaged Japan in a series of civil wars lasting for nearly 100 years. It came to an end when Oda Nobunaga broke the power of the feudal lords and of the monasteries. His successor, Toyotomi Hideyoshi, who came to power in 1582, united Japan by 1590. The third unifier, Ieyasu Tokugawa, finally brought the long-lasting peace to Japan since the early 17th century. This period is known as Momoyama period. Trade relations with Europe expanded rapidly and a new wealthy class of merchants emerged. Like in the European Renaissance period, this new class contributed and influenced the development of arts. Screen painting and the art of ceramic objects flourished. Numerous castles were built by local lords. The Himeji Castle, also called the White Heron Castle in the today's extension, was constructed from 1601 to 1609. According to historians, as many as 50,000 people worked on its completion. The most important school of painting in the Momoyama period was that of the Kanno school, and the greatest innovation of the period was the formula developed by Kanno Ietoku for the creation of monumental landscapes on the sliding doors enclosing a room. The decoration of the main room facing the garden of the Juko-in, a sub-temple of Daitoku-ji, a Zen temple in Kyoto, is perhaps the best extant example of Ietoku's work. Ietoku's screen, Chinese Lions, also in Kyoto, reveals the bold, brightly colored style of painting preferred by the samurai. Hasegawa Tohaku, a contemporary of Ietoku, developed a somewhat different and more decorative style for large-scale screen paintings in his Maple Screen, now in the temple of Chisaku in Kyoto. He placed the trunk of the tree in the center and extended the limbs nearly to the edge of the composition, creating a flatter, less architectonic work than Ietoku, but a visually appealing painting. His six-fold screen, Pinewood, is a masterly rendering in monochrome ink of a grove of trees enveloped in mist. The Edo period is also called the Tokugawa period after the name of the shogunate that ruled over Japan for 256 years. The Tokugawa brought peace and stability to the country, but at the cost of a repressive political style. During the Tokugawa reign, contacts with the outside world were completely stopped in 1624. Nagasaki was the only port open for commercial contacts with the outside world. Edo, today Tokyo, and Osaka were the economic and cultural centers of the Edo period. A wealthy new urban class gained influence in this period. The arts moved away from the aristocratic background and showed scenes from the life of common people. From a cultural point of view, the Edo period was something like the pop culture of swinging London in the 60s and early 70s of the 20th century. In the early years of the Edo period, however, the full impact of Tokugawa policies had not yet been felt, and some of Japan's finest expressions in architecture and painting were produced. Katsura Palace in Kyoto and the paintings of Tawaraya Sotatsu, pioneer of the Rinpa school. Sotatsu evolved a superb decorative style by recreating themes from classical literature, using brilliantly colored figures and motifs from the natural world set against gold leaf backgrounds. One of his finest works is the pair of screens, the waves at Matsushima, now in the Freer Gallery in Washington. Century later, Korin reworked Sotatsu's style and created visually gorgeous works uniquely his own. Perhaps his finest are the screen paintings of red and white plum blossoms. During the Edo period, a new style of painting emerged in which whole pieces were painted with gold leaf backgrounds, producing an effect much like religious mosaics of the Western medieval period. It was also during this time period that the ukiyo-e style of woodblock printing began to emerge. This represented a break from other Japanese art forms In that wood block, prints were reproducible. A middle-class family could own a copy of a famous piece of art. The first ukiyo-e in black and white was produced in the late 17th century. Around 1764, Harunobu was the first, or at least the first popular artist who introduced polychrome printing. The dominant master in the late 18th century was undoubtedly Utamaro, famous for his sensitive depictions of courtesans from the amusement quarters. Utamaro produced over 2,000 prints during his working career, along with a number of paintings, surimono, as well as many illustrated books, including over 30 shunga books, albums and related publications. Among his best known works are the series 10 Studies in Female Physiognomy, a collection of reigning beauties, great love themes of classical poetry, sometimes called Women in Love, containing individual prints such as Revealed Love and Pensive Love, and 12 Hours in the Pleasure Quarters. He alone of his contemporary ukiyo-e artists achieved a national reputation during his lifetime. His sensuous female beauties generally are considered the finest and most evocative in all of ukiyo-e. He succeeded in capturing subtle aspects of personality and transient moods of women of all classes, ages and circumstances. His reputation has remained undiminished since his work is known worldwide, and he is generally regarded as one of the half dozen greatest ukiyo-e artists of all time. Another school of painting contemporary with ukiyo-e was Bunjinga, a style based on paintings executed by Chinese scholar painters. Just as ukiyo-e artists chose to depict figures from life outside the strictures of the Tokugawa shogunate, Bunjinga artists turned to Chinese culture. The exemplars of this style are the Aike no Taiga, Yosabusen, Tanomuro Chikuden and Yamamoto Baitsu. In the 19th century, the dominant figure was Hiroshige, a creator of romantic and somewhat sentimental landscape prints. The odd angles and shapes through which Hiroshige often viewed landscape and the work of Kiyonaga and Utamaro, with its emphasis on flat planes and strong linear outlines, had a profound impact on such Western artists as Edgar Degas and Vincent van Gogh. Hiroshige was a member of the Utagawa school along with Kunisada and Kuniyoshi. The Utagawa school comprised dozens of artists and stood at the forefront of 19th century woodblock prints. Hiroshige's career falls roughly into three periods. From 1811 to about 1830, he created prints of traditional subjects such as young women and actors. During the next 15 years, he won fame as a landscape artist, reaching a peak of success and achievement in 1833 when his masterpiece, the print series 53 Stations of the Tokaido, Scenes on the Highway, connecting Edo and Kyoto, was published. He maintained his high level of craftsmanship in other travel series, including Celebrated Places in Japan and 69 Stations on the Kiso Highway. The work he did during the third period, the last years of his life, is sometimes of lesser quality, as he appears to have hurriedly met the demands of popularity. He died in 1858. His total output was immense, some 5,400 prints in all. Katsushika Hokusai was another well-known ukiyo-e painter and printmaker of the Edo period. He was influenced by such painters as Sishu and other styles of Chinese painting. He is best known as the author of the woodblock print series, 36 Views of Mount Fuji, which includes the internationally recognized print, The Great Wave of Kanagawa, created during the 1820s. Hokusai created the 36 views both as a response to a domestic travel boom and as part of a personal obsession with Mount Fuji. It was this series, specifically the great wave print and Fuji in clear weather, that secured Hokusai's fame both in Japan and overseas. As historian Richard Lane concludes, indeed, if there is one work that made Hokusai's name both in Japan and abroad, it must be this monumental print series. Hokusai learned from Dutch and French pastoral landscapes the use of perspective, shading and realistic shadows and used them in his works. More importantly, he introduced the serenity of nature and the unity of man and his surroundings into Japanese popular art. Instead of shoguns, samurai and their geishas, which were the common topics of Japanese illustrative art at the time, Hokusai placed the common man into his woodblocks, moving the emphasis away from the aristocrats and to the rest of humanity. In the great wave, tiny humans are tossed around under giant waves, while enormous Mount Fuji is a hill in the distance. When Emperor of Japan regained ruling power in 1868, this period is also called the Meiji Restoration. Japan was once again invaded by new forms of culture. During the pre-war period, the introduction of the Western cultural values led to a dichotomy in Japanese art. As well as in nearly every other aspect of culture, between traditional values and attempts to assimilate a variety of clashing new ideas. This split remained evident in the late 20th century, although much synthesis had by then already occurred and created an international culture atmosphere which stimulated contemporary Japanese arts toward ever more innovative forms. Now, let us summarize this session. The discussion about Japanese art starts with its early inhibitors called Ainu and ends with the 20th century developments in art. Important art schools and artists in each historical period are also being discussed at length. Find out examples for Japanese influence in Western modern art and explain. Collect images of different formats of Japanese paintings and prepare an album. Kiefer Hetcham and W.O.G. Sikhinge, The Fascinating World of the Japanese Artist. Addis Stephen, How to Look at Japanese Art. New York, Abrahams. Hutt, Julia, Understanding Far Eastern Art. Oxford, Fiden. Masson, Penelope, History of Japanese Art. Upper Saddle River, N.J. Pearson Prentice Hall. Hope you enjoyed this session. Let us meet in next session. Till then, bye.